Good morning, everyone. Flying dinosaurs.
Yes, indeed, they existed. We are at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History, the Pterosaurs, Flight in the Age of Dinosaurs. How big is a flying dinosaur? Well, they have a little mock-up. Yeah, that's one of them, and that's not even the biggest one. Can you imagine that thing flying over the coastline? That'll kind of make you scared. I mean, probably wouldn't want to go to Edgewater Park if you saw that bad boy flying everywhere. But we're going to give you a twofer. But wait, there's more. We're going to give you a twofer. This exhibit is here, and they're also starting another exhibit, which is also equally interesting. What's also interesting is that my crew can back up and not hit anything. That's pretty awesome. And this is Wendy. All right, good morning.
Good morning.
So Wendy, we're gonna talk about flying dinosaurs, and then we're also gonna talk about this exhibit, which is very interesting as well. Mm-hmm. It's called Sailing for Science. Now, what's it all about?
It's all about the museum's first scientific collecting expedition, 1923 to 1926.
So this is the expedition where they jumped in a massive sailboat and went out to find the stuff for the museum?
That's right. That's right. They went to the islands in the South Atlantic.
Wow.
On a wooden ship with no engine.
On a wooden ship with no engine and no FedEx to fed back off, you
That's
know, FedEx
right.
all the stuff back. So that it lasted how long?
Nearly 3 years.
Nearly 3 years.
31 months, 20,000 miles.
Wow. With a ship with no motor. Okay. Well, that's going to be interesting.
Okay.
And that's going to be really cool because there's a lot of great stories about this as well, right?
Great stories, yes.
All right. Flying dinosaurs and Wendy telling great stories. There you go. That's what we had this morning. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Fox 8 News at 7 o'clock starts right now.